Alright, let's get started. Let's get started. Places. Places, everyone. We don't have much time tonight. Not much time at all.
You do know you're repeating everything twice, right?
What?
Twice.
What? What?
Exactly.
Never mind. I don't have time for this. Okay, is everyone here? Yes, Riley. Can you stand right over there, please?
Are you kidding?
Yes, good. Perfect. Alright, let's get things started. Quiet.
No, it's really good. Donald Trump will ruin Christmas for everyone.
No, there will be no political agenda tonight. Christmas is a time for everyone, regardless of their political affiliation. Okay. Is everyone ready now? Good, okay. Tonight, the Creative Arts Department at Trinity Christian Academy would like to present to you an original poem entitled Reflections on Christmas.
Or The Night Before Doom!
No, Riley, what are you doing?
Nothing. I was just trying to make it less boring.
Well, I'll be the one to decide what's up. Anyway, okay. Is everyone ready now? Thank you. A cold, crisp winter night and gently falling snow, and then the soft and fading light of fire all aglow.
Wait, what? Hold on.
What?
Is that a British accent I hear? Because literally the only thing that can make this more boring is if it were read in a British accent.
It's a reflection. It must be read in a British accent.
Well, it's not my cup of tea, but whatever.
Yes, cup of tea. Very funny. Now, if you don't mind. Quiet, young ones, slumber above the world below and sleep in awe, in wonder, in peaceful, safe abodes.
And in the dark and quiet, something epic stirred. Soon, there would be a riot and a shark driving a tank, shooting fireworks and an electric guitar!
No, what have you done?
Nothing. I was making it more awesome.
I'll also be the one to decide what's awesome here. I am the narrator, after all. Now, as I was saying, or reflecting, but lo, they dreamt of sugar plums dancing in their heads.
Hold on.
Was
don't you think we should be a little more sensitive? I mean, I don't know if we should be encouraging unhealthy eating habits like that.
Sugar plums.
Well, yeah, I'm pretty sure there are several people in this audience on either gluten-free or paleo diets. You wouldn't want to be responsible for giving them unwanted cravings, would you?
My mom didn't go on the low carb diet. I haven't eaten sugar in 8 weeks.
See, we can't use our position on the stage to negatively influence the children.
Oh, who cares about the children?
I mean,
children do matter. It's just... Yes. Wait, no.
He hates kids!
I don't hate kids. I don't hate kids. Sugar plums are a staple of Christmas. And just for the record, I don't hate kids or the environment or animals for you PETA activists. But lo, they dreamt of sugar plums dancing in their heads, waiting in earnest till morning comes and nestling snugly in their beds. Okay. Forget ye not the years gone by when a star above did shine. A manger and a babe did lie. O gift of life.
Just really quick, one last time. I'm really sorry. But speaking of gifts, can someone please explain to me what frankincense is? Frankincense?
It's okay.
It's alive!
It's frankincense, not Frankenstein.
Well, do you even know what frankincense is?
No. No one does. Angels sang of joy to all. The Lord had come at last. In the form of one so small, our cares on him we cast.
That's really good, my last one. I'm really sorry. But don't you think that escalated a bit, just a bit quickly?
Escalated? How so?
I mean, you went from gently falling snow to sugar plums. to kids sleeping, and then all of a sudden the angels were singing.
Yes, and what's wrong with that?
No offense, but if I were, you know, writing this, I might make a smoother transition.
Smooth like a hairless cat.
Hairless cats aren't even smooth.
You're not.
Well, let's just finish up and go home.
Wait, isn't that kind of the point?
What are you talking about? Going home? Having your one chance to make a halfway decent Christmas show with a British accent. Mm-hmm. And all while leaving the audience with that nice, pleasant, feel-good feeling, revealing to them the true meaning of Christmas, and then having it smashed to bits during the performance. Is that what you're trying to say, Hannah? Is that why all of these people are still sitting out here in the audience? Hey, sir, I see you trying to get them to walk out. Sorry. Oh, it's unbelievable. This is hopeless.
Yeah, that's exactly what I mean.
I was being sarcastic.
But I wasn't. Just listen. That's the point, Clay. We're showing people what Christmas is all about. All of us right here with all of our silly ideas and all of our outbursts. Do you think it was Mary's idea of perfection to have her baby in a stable? The whole point of Christmas is to bring peace to our violence, order to our chaos. Perfection came down to walk around in our imperfection. You see, the point of Christmas is not about being perfect. In fact, it's the complete opposite. It's about hope, about a savior rescuing us from our mess. It's God's way of giving us a way to fix our brokenness. It's not about acting like that brokenness doesn't exist.
Well, I never thought about it like that. So is it all right that this poem is so weird?
Sure it is. It's even kind of funny that way. Just look at that lady right over there. She was laughing like crazy.
Well, so it turned out all right, huh?
But how does the poem end?
Well, how about something like this? A Christmas time is now in sight.
For people everywhere. It doesn't have to be just right if our hearts are found sincere.
And with bold, pure hearts, we shall not be skittish, for we shall create
something epic!
Something brilliant! Something on!
Something British!
Boring!
From all of us, to all of you, let the real meaning of Christmas be loud and true. Thank you, and good night.
Oh.